she pop them collars. Around here we get them dollars. Every girl I see that look right like me just got a holler. This kid here all about stacking up. Tall, big head, but we can back it up. Long as everybody get crunk when they drop in the club, start acting up. I represent the S-O-S-O-D-E-F-M-O-B.
We instantly hit it off. Alright y'all, welcome back to the motherfucking channel, man. Today we're gonna be reacting to disturbing Gorilla Glue horror story animations, I believe it is. This is from MJV Animations. We're just gonna go ahead and hop into it, man. Gorilla Glue already sounds crazy right here. I got me some Grape Ape. It ain't no Gorilla Glue, but I got me some Grape Ape. And we're gonna go ahead and, you know, enjoy this. Those Degrassi. I already did the first Degrassi reaction, but those Degrassi reactions in general, I'm going to just like slowly ease into those, you know what I'm saying? And then I'll end up doing them, you know, consistently and shit like that. So I just wanted to let y'all know that in case, you know, y'all fuck with that reaction. Y'all go tune into that because that will be dropped before this. So by the time y'all seeing this, y'all should have already seen that Degrassi reaction. So let me go ahead and, oh shit. Let me go ahead and hop into this shit. Alright.
I met Kyle 5 months ago at the gym.
Right.
I was on the machine that trains your glutes.
Okay.
My phone fell out of my armband and ripped my earphones with it. Kyle ran over from the leg machine to pick it up for me, and we instantly hit it off. I remember the way he looked me up and down. He had piercing green eyes that seemed to stare right through me.
Okay.
And when our eyes met, I felt a jolt run through my spine. I've never felt such an attraction to anyone before. The next couple of weeks, we met every day at the gym. We would help each other train. We would flirt. And his confidence and stature would send shivers down my body every time.
Mm-hmm.
I was hooked. I was always fiercely independent. I'd left home at 18 and built up my own painting and decorating business. I hated That's the idea that. Of ever being dependent on anyone for anything. I took pride in being a successful woman in a male-dominated field of work. By the start of 2020, I had 10 full-time employees, 3 apprentices, and work contracts both that would keep the business busy until October. Kyle had such an effect on me. My pride went out the window whenever I saw him.
Right.
And I felt myself becoming further drawn into him. By 2 weeks, he was spending time with me at home. We bonded perfectly. It was like we were made for each other. Kyle unofficially moved in after that, and we spent the rest of February and March in a blur of training together at the gym, and spending time at home. Coronavirus hit and lockdown hit harder. All of my domestic contracts had to be suspended, leaving a few commercial business ones to divide between my employees.
Right.
I furloughed half of them and decided to suspend my own salary and live off savings in a bid to keep the business running.
That's what's up.
I stayed at home with Kyle, spending a few hours a day on admin at first.
Right.
But eventually, I left that to my most senior employee and spent every hour of my day with Kyle. April and May flew by. Kyle and I were inseparable. We would wake up together, cook and eat together, clean together, go to sleep together. And by the end of May, we were already planning to tie the knot.
Right.
I was completely addicted to him. He was infatuated with me. All notion of independence and individualism faded from my mind. I was Kyle's, and Kyle was mine. Conversation became few and far between.
Which is crazy.
We seemed to just know what the other wanted to do. The conversation we did have usually involved gushing over each other and laying on compliment after compliment. June passed by even faster. I was screening calls for my employees and clients. I no longer cared for my own business. Kyle was my career now. We were two pieces of a jigsaw that fit perfectly together. You have to understand that, even by early June, I wasn't concerned in the slightest. I was perfectly happy, but something happened. Something changed everything. One evening 2 weeks ago, I was cuddling with Kyle in bed. He was playing with my hair and cooing words like, beautiful and stunning into my ear. He then said to me, I never want to be apart from you. I would glue us together if I could. I let out a happy sigh and agreed with it. I said, I'd love to be stuck with you forever. We could stay snuggling for the rest of our lives.
I knew it.
I looked up at Kyle, and his piercing green eyes bore into me. I smiled, and Kyle grinned, and then we both sighed in unison. And soon, I was drifting off into sleep. I woke up around dawn. I couldn't move.
Wow.
Kyle was wrapped around me, spooning me. I tried to wriggle free just a bit to stretch my arms and legs, but I could not move. This was weird, I thought. Kyle was holding me, sure, but he wasn't grabbing me in a vice grip.
Right.
I tried to move again, this time with more effort. Fuck! I had screeched. My skin had pulled and torn around my neck. I remembered my body suddenly filling with adrenaline and anxiety. Kyle? Kyle, wake up! What's going on? I shakenly shouted out.
Turn it down just a little bit.
Kyle calmly whispered in my ear. Shh, baby. We're glued together, remember? Just like you said you wanted.
Wow.
My eyes widened. The adrenaline already coursing through my body increased tenfold. Right. All the obsession and addiction I felt towards this man just fell away from my brain.
Right.
I screamed, what the actual hell, Kyle? You glued us together? Again, Kyle replied in a whimsical whisper. Yeah, baby girl. Isn't it wonderful? You have some really good in your work things. I just made our wish come true.
Wow.
Time stood still for me. Where I once thought the sun shined out of Kyle, now all I could think was how much of a weirdo psychopath he was.
He'd been like
that. I tried to pull free from Kyle again.
I feel like he'd been like sus. He'd been sus.
It tore around my neck and parts of my body. Blood had started to trickle down. And I instinctively moved an arm to scratch the itch I had caused.
Right.
This was a bad mistake. My arm felt like someone was pulling at my skin with 1,000 tweezers. It would not bulge. I screamed again. Fuck! I managed to turn my head just enough to look back at Kyle. His face was contorted into a forced, teethy grin. His skin looked pale in the morning sunlight. His eyes were wide open. I swear, he didn't blink at all. Beautiful.
The fuck,
he whispered from his stretched out mouth, his eyes drilling into mine. This man was insane. I screamed. I took a breath. I screamed again. My body was going into shock. My body started to shake.
Wow.
Again, that was such a mistake. Pain erupted all over my skin as 1,000 tweezer pinches became 100,000.
This is ridiculous.
This was shock I needed, though. The pain had set something off in my brain. I knew that I needed to get free of him. I also knew how painful
you should. I feel like she should have been left.
I began with my arms. I started off slowly trying to pull them away from him. Our skin was so tightly stuck together. The pain was so immense. But I kept going.
Right.
I had to get away from this ghoul of a man. I pulled harder and harder until the top layer of the skin peeled off. My left arm was free. I screeched out in agony. I could hear Kyle whispering behind me again.
Right.
Stunning. The hairs
He's
in the back
part
of my neck that wasn't glued stood to attention. It was like I was in a nightmare, and some demon was conjured in my dreams right behind me. I pushed on and pulled my right arm free, screaming the whole time.
What the fuck, cuz?
Blood was pouring out of my arms. I jerked my head forward in determination, and the rest of my neck peeled away from Kyle's chest.
Right. Ooh.
I couldn't begin to fathom why Kyle wasn't crying out in pain. I was ripping away as much of his skin as I was mine.
Ooh.
As I began to focus on my legs, I felt something wet slide down my neck. Then I heard a slurp and lips smacking together. Thirsty. Nope, I screamed in my head. I went for it and ripped my legs away from his in one clean motion.
Was he drinking her blood?
Pain is a word for what I felt. I don't know how much glue Kyle had used on her legs, but the skin tore apart so much that I could see patches of muscle glistening with the blood that was streaming out. I passed out. I came to as my body jolted around.
Oh my
Kyle
God.
Had picked me up and taken me into the hallway. I shouted, what are you doing? Kyle replied, again, as calm as anything. We need more glue. No, 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 no. I turned my head again to look at him. His teethy grin seemed even wider. His eyes had turned bloodshot with the veins tingling together towards his bright green irises.
What the fuck,
his breath smelt of blood. my blood.
He would have had to die.
In a desperate attempt to get away, I jerked my body weight forward. I felt a searing pain down my back as if I had just been
anyone like this, no matter what, in any situation, friendship.
I fell face first onto the floor, with Kyle on top of me.
You gotta go.
As we fell, I heard a bone crunching and crack. Kyle? Kyle? I felt around his body as much as my arms could maneuver, but Kyle wasn't moving. I noticed a trickle of blood stream past my face as I realized Kyle must have hit his head on something on the way down.
Shit,
I used all my strength to lift us both up. As my back lifted up, I suddenly felt a lot lighter. Kyle's body had slumped off me. I was free, bleeding profusely from my back and all parts of my body, and feeling more and more lightheaded.
This shit probably happened. This shit probably really happened in real life.
I turned around briefly to look at Kyle, his body lifeless, but that grin and wide-eyed expression still stuck on its face.
Wow.
I opened the front door, tumbled out into the fresh air, bloody. I ran as fast as I could for a good 10 minutes, desperately searching for anyone who could help me. I stopped to catch my breath. A sudden cold morning breeze stung every millimeter of my skin, and I let out a guttural animalistic cry as I fell to the pavement. Before I passed out again, I saw a woman and a dog walk towards me. A wave of relief rushed through my body as my brain shut down. Apparently, the woman with the dog called for an ambulance.
Good.
I spent a week in a hospital in an induced medical coma to help heal my skin and shield me from the pain. I've been awake and relatively lucid for the past few days.
Right.
I'm on heavy painkillers, and my whole body is pretty much bandaged up, but I'm doing okay considering.
Sorry, I ain't saying
much. I asked about Kyle when I woke up.
Am I really?
They didn't know who I was talking about. Right. I've been unconscious since arriving at the hospital. They rang the police for me, and I gave them a short statement and permission to enter my house.
Mm-hmm.
They came back to my hospital room the next day.
He gone.
With news that no body had been found.
Wow.
But they did see blood all over the floor and walls.
That nigga gone.
They've made inquiries around other hospitals in the area.
Oh.
Just in case a man of Kyle's description and injuries have been taken in. But I've not heard anything back yet. A counselor and full PPE
that nigga
here
was
dropped
gone.
By earlier today to talk with me. I shared my story with her as best as I could. She told me that what I've gone through, it sounded like obsessive love disorder, OLD,
right.
Which me and Kyle had both developed.
Wow.
She said it sounded like Kyle had developed a form of psychosis.
Yeah, but she had it first,
OLD,
though.
But she couldn't say for certain.
No, she had
perhaps
that first.
She'd always been suffering with mental health, and I just didn't know.
Because she was like, yeah, I'm obsessed
so
with something,
severe,
da-da-da-da-da. She
said
that off
the psychotic
episode. Like, yeah, his this, his that.
I don't know.
Tell me, man, that's what you gotta do to that nigga, man. That nigga came back. That nigga came back. They need to make MJV, if you ever see this shit, y'all gotta make another fucking, like, a sequel to this one. Like, y'all got to. Like, this shit was crazy, man. Make sure I'm motherfucking subscribe, man. I'm just trying to hop back into these reactions. I'm really trying to get into the groove, man. I'm really trying to get into the groove of things. Y'all just bear with me, man. I got some shit in tune for y'all, man. I mean, I got some shit in the holster for y'all. Y'all gonna love it, man. I'm telling y'all. I'm out.
My name is D. This one goes out to everybody all around the world. Dog to dog, girl to girl.
Yeah.
I need y'all to help me spell my name.
Come on.
Bad. Outstanding.
W.
Everybody know I'm the wickedest.